Happy Monday, ladies and gentlemen. Mackenzie Lambert here, your host for Mech and the Movies. Sorry for the late upload, but I'm going to make up for it today with uploading both this episode as well as the last episode for the Fritz Lang series. We started with Dr. Mabuse, Der Spieler, and continued through the film we looked at last time, Woman in the Window. Today, we look at another noir entry, but unlike Woman in the Window, this one is more consistent in tone. Let's take a look at Scarlet Street, starring Edward G. Robinson, Joan Bennett, and Danny Duryea. Crisscross is a meek cashier who sometimes dabbles in painting. He is given a watch and a few congratulatory words at the 25th anniversary of his employment at J.J. Hogarth & Company. Then, his boss is led out to his chauffeured town car with a lovely gal waiting for him. Chris wonders what it's like to be loved by a younger woman. Chris's life puts that thought into perspective. He works a meager job for less than modest wages. He is in a marriage with Adele, a woman who barely tolerates his presence. She frequently brings up her late husband, a cop who died while trying to rescue a drowning woman. One night, he encounters Kitty, who is being attacked by a young man. Chris comes to her rescue, knocking down the attacker, then goes to fetch the police. When Chris returns with the officer, the man is gone. Chris and Kitty share a drink at the local bar. The conversation leads Kitty to think Chris is a wealthy painter. Kitty is soon escorted home by Chris. It turns out the attacker was Kitty's boyfriend Johnny, a common con artist. They come up with a scheme to sucker Chris out of his supposed wealth, not realizing he's just an average layman. The situation soon escalates. Chris buys Kitty a new apartment. A prominent art critic notices Chris's work, but Johnny puts the credit to Kitty. Then Adele's supposedly dead husband ends up coming back to try to take Adele's insurance money. It takes the twisty turns one would expect from a film noir. But unlike Woman in the Window, Scarlet Street doesn't obliterate the emotional investment of the viewer up to any point. There is no everything was a dream ending. The movie takes a fairly dark turn in the last third of the film, then manages to go even darker as Chris is to forever be haunted by the events of the film. Like most noir, Scarlet Street is a morality tale. The film serves as a warning to the crisscrosses of the world. Men with high aspirations, but are at a stage in life where they think their prime is past. The film essentially tells them they should be happy with where they are in life. To get ahead in life through sneaky means would only cause greater harm to others and to themselves. It almost feels like Scarlet Street was made as an apology of sorts to fans of Lang. Woman in the Window wasn't a film that was true to itself, which was corrected with Scarlet Street. According to IMDb, this is one of Fritz Lang's personal favorites of his filmography. I can understand why. Much like his past work, this one doesn't have him pulling punches. You can see the grim tone of films like M and Testament of Dr. Mabuse, with the dismissal of censor concerns as seen in Manhunt. Despite protests by concerns in New York, Georgia, and Wisconsin, the film was released through Universal. To further add to the notion that Scarlet Street was a course correction of sorts, a few of the principal cast return. Edward G. Robinson plays Crisscross, the relatable everyman not happy with where he is in life. Joan Bennett plays the polar opposite of the love interest in either Manhunt or Woman in the Window. In fact, she plays a downright evil woman. As Johnny, Duryea is pretty much a carbon copy of Height from Woman in the Window. Scarlet Street feels like the film Woman in the Window should have been, but RKO Pictures didn't have the guts to stay true to the original script. Leave it to Universal, a studio known for its supernatural monsters, to be willing to show the monsters within humanity. Scarlet Street is a solid film in the later career of Fritz Lang. And that finishes this look at Scarlet Street. Thanks for watching. Feel free to share your thoughts in the comments below. Later today, I'm going to be taking a look at Secret Beyond the Door. Until then, this is Mackenzie Lambert with Mech and the Movies. Take care.